It's pretty clear that guys don't like talking about their bodies. Even science doesn't have all the answers. So it's time to pull back the curtain, fellas. Here's a look at some things most men secretly do to and with their bodies, even if they wouldn't admit it all. It's safe to say many guys like to think of themselves as fit, athletic types. However, there's a good chance that even dedicated gym rats spend more time sitting than is good for them. While too much sitting is unhealthy, according to the Mayo Clinic, the solution is not to balance out sitting time with exercise. Instead, you should avoid spending big chunks of time being sedentary. Michael Fredrickson, physician and director of PM&R Sports Medicine at the Stanford University Medical Center, told Men's Health, "Thinking that you can sit all day and then just go to the gym at night and counteract all that sitting? That would be false. Our bodies were meant to move." The American Heart Association, for example, has stated that even people who exercise regularly could be at increased risk for heart disease and stroke if they spend too much time sitting down. On the other hand, studies show that taking 5-minute walks, spending less time sitting overall, and taking multiple breaks to get up and move throughout the day have been found to offset this risk. Guys like a neatly mowed lawn, but you might be surprised how many of them extend that predilection to do some personal manscaping. In one study of college-age participants, 95% of the men and women reported removing at least some pubic hair in the previous 4 weeks, and 49% of those men preferred shaving over other means of hair removal. That study also found that nearly a quarter, 23.7% of the men, reported having injured themselves in the process at least once. Laceration was the most common injury, and the scrotum was the most common side of misfortune. Experience seems to play a role here. Injury was more common among younger men and those who'd started grooming earlier in life. Grooming in a standing position was associated with the higher likelihood of injury. Fortunately, only a small fraction, 9.3% of injuries, resulted in an infection, and even fewer cases, 2.5%, required surgery or sutures. Yes, even asleep, it seems guys have one thing on their mind. This was one finding in a sleep study of dream enacting behaviors, that is, making motions and actions while dreaming. Typically, our brain keeps us from making movements while we dream, but it can still happen, sometimes due to a sleep disorder. Researchers found that 98% of participants had experienced a dream enacting behavior at least once. There was only one statistically meaningful difference between the male and female survey respondents. Men were more likely to report sexual arousal relating to the behavior, while women reported more emotional reactions like crying, laughing, speaking, or fear. Nighttime arousal is actually a pretty common thing that happens to the male body. Men can have several erections during the course of the night. Not all of them are linked to arousal, though.
You don't have to be embarrassed about it.
What?
Morning wood is not a big deal. There's a reason why that happened.
You may think that men immediately go to sleep after sex, but that's not true. Or at least it's not true that they're more likely to do so than a female partner. As part of a study published in Journal of Social, Evolutionary, and Cultural Psychology, researchers investigated what goes on during the postcoital time interval. They surveyed 456 sexually active college-aged men and women who identified as heterosexual, but questioning them on their sleeping habits revealed no statistical difference between reports of men or women being the first to doze off. However, the data show that if no intimacy occurred between a couple, women were more likely to fall asleep first. According to the researchers, this could be the remnant of a mate-guarding instinct on the part of men to prevent their partner from sneaking away for a tryst with another caveman. Or it might be due to men holding out hope that their partner will get in the mood. A large body of research suggests that men, in general, take more risks than women. This may contribute to the higher rates of alcoholism, death from car accidents, risky financial decisions, problem gambling, and other risk-related consequences among men. It also seems that risky behavior is a way that men handle stress. A study published in PLOS ONE examined this by having men and women participate in a standard computer game that measures risk-taking. They could earn money by inflating an on-screen balloon, but would lose it all if they inflated it too much and the balloon broke.
You look a little stressed.
Oh, I'm stressed.
Under normal conditions, men and women inflated the balloon an equal amount, indicating an equal tendency to take a risk. But when put under stress by placing a hand in ice-cold water for 3 minutes, men tended to take more risks in the game, while the women did not. The researchers suggested that men and women may have inherited different responses to stress because, evolutionarily speaking, our male ancestors fought for territory, while our female ancestors needed to be more cautious about putting their young in danger. An unconscious behavior that body language experts call the crotch display is one of several signals that a man is attracted to someone. And it's pretty much what it sounds like – standing or sitting with legs spread, loins in full view. Other cues for attraction include stroking his tie or lapel or pulling up his socks, buttoning and unbuttoning his jacket, and touching his face, according to Today. Sometimes men will also hook their thumbs into their belt loops, essentially pointing toward what he considers his best feature. Body language expert Alan Pease told She Said, "Men use this gesture to stake their territory or to show other men that they are unafraid. This gesture tells others, 'I am virile. I can dominate.'" In general, men die earlier. One such reason for this is that men are more likely to be employed in dangerous jobs. In fact, compared to women, men are 10 times more likely to be killed on the job, according to Forbes. In 2019, nearly 5,000 men suffered fatal occupational injuries, compared to 437 women, per Statista. As Forbes revealed, fishing workers had the highest fatal injury rate, followed by logging workers, aircraft pilots, and roofers. Transportation incidents, including crashes and other accidents involving land vehicles, trains, or aircrafts, account for the biggest share of fatalities. Overall, the safest jobs are indoors and require some college education, while the most dangerous involve working outdoors and operating equipment. Public spitting isn't as common as it used to be, in part thanks to widespread anti-spitting legislation that was intended to prevent the spread of tuberculosis at the dawn of the 20th century. These anti-spitting campaigns were at least partly about eliminating a gross habit that American men had been indulging in since the colonial days. Public spittoons may be a thing of the past, but who hasn't witnessed somebody casually launch a gob of wet saliva onto the sidewalk? And isn't that somebody usually a dude? The connection between spitting and manliness is cultural, not biological, according to dentist and author Susan Maples. She told Women's Health that there is no evidence that men produce more saliva than women, nor do men have some other physical reason that they must share their saliva with the world. It's just a learned habitual way of expressing manliness. Sometimes called by the pseudoscientific name of postmicturition convulsion syndrome, the phenomenon of feeling a sudden shiver while urinating, aka pee shivers, isn't well studied. Though this is perhaps as it should be. Science has more important problems to solve, after all. Anecdotally, pee shivers seem to be a mostly male experience. The cause of the sometimes messy bathroom occurrence isn't known, gastroenterologist and author Anish Sheth told NBC News. He explained that one theory pins the reaction to a result of blood pressure lowering during urination. Sometimes this natural blood pressure drop is large enough to activate a corrective response from the nervous system, which triggers the shivering reflex as a side effect. He also noted that since men urinate standing up, they're more likely to feel the effect of blood pressure dropping, which could be why the experience is more common in men. There are different names for this maneuver, but we'll call it the old scratch and sniff. Often it starts as a routine below the belt adjustment, but once his hand is out of his pants, there's an almost irresistible urge to take a whiff of those busy fingers. A Reddit thread sharing disgusting things men do in private revealed this to be a pretty common activity. It's been suggested that this is some kind of hygiene instinct, but the explanation may actually be surprisingly existential. In an interview with Mel magazine, biopsychologist Nigel Barber speculated that the behavior is akin to looking in a mirror. He said, "The perception of self may elevate mood and boost self-esteem." According to this theory, perceiving our own body odor reminds us that we're unique individuals, reinforcing our sense of self. You have to admire the optimism. In a Mayo Clinic study that queried nearly 3,000 men and women about how they viewed their own health, men and women had equal confidence in their ability to eat a healthy diet. However, men tended to have more confidence than women that they could maintain healthy exercise habits. The numbers also showed that men and women rated themselves as equally healthy. That might seem fine, except that the men in the study had higher rates of health problems like hypertension, high cholesterol, cigarette smoking, and diabetes. That suggests a gap between perception and reality, according to the researchers. Richa Sood, internist and author of the study, said in a statement about her research, "We were surprised by the finding that men felt they were as healthy as women despite having more medical problems." Research shows that men and women eat differently. Men have been found to eat a less healthy diet, but what is it that motivates this dietary difference?
Don't you worry about cholesterol, lung cancer, love handles?
I don't worry about anything.
The answer seems to be wrapped up in cultural beliefs about masculinity and femininity. A pair of experiments published in Social Psychology investigated this by having volunteers complete a word puzzle task that included stereotypically masculine or feminine terms like football or ballet, for example. Then they polled the study subjects for their food preferences. The results showed that exposure to masculine words made people more likely to favor unhealthy versions of the same food, like fried chicken versus baked, more likely to say that they would eat unhealthy foods in the future, and less likely to claim specific healthy eating behaviors, like eating more vegetables. A follow-up study found that people rated food as better tasting if it came in gendered packaging that matched a stereotype. For example, a mega muffin in masculine packaging was rated higher than a health muffin in the same packaging. Who should pay when a man and a woman go out to lunch? In terms of fairness, maybe the guy. Why? Because chances are that he's eating almost twice as much as he does when dining alone. In a study conducted at an Italian restaurant, researchers tracked the amounts of pizza and salad consumed by customers during an all-you-can-eat lunch buffet special. Although the diners knew they were participating in a study, they didn't know it was about their eating habits. In the end, researchers found that men who were dining with women consumed 93% more pizza and 86% more salad than men eating with other men. Women's eating behavior, on the other hand, didn't change based on dining partners. According to the researchers, this behavior may be an evolutionary one, a type of showing off that men unconsciously do in the presence of women. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Health Digest videos about healthy habits are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.